Of all the apparitions of the Blessed Virgin Mary, none has so captivated the world as her appearance to three children at Fatima in Portugal in 1917. The three children were Lucia dos Santos and her cousins Jacinta and Francisco Marto. They were poor and had little education. Yet one day, while they were tending sheep, they found themselves conversing with an angel. The angel taught them how to grow in their practice of prayer, and he encouraged them to make sacrifices. He seemed to be preparing them for some great task. The nature of that task became clear on May 13th of that year, when the children were visited by a lady who was luminous, brighter than the sun, they said, with a light that was purer than crystal. Her message to the children was much like the message they heard from the angel. She urged them to pray and do penance. The children agreed among themselves not to tell anyone about their heavenly visitors, but Jacinta let slip with her mother, and soon, well, the whole village knew. Then word spread beyond the village. Crowds began to gather around the children on the 13th day of each month, the day the lady regularly appeared. Portugal, like many countries during that time, was experiencing a heavy-handed wave of secularization. Revolutionary movements throughout Europe sought to weaken the church's influence, and they did this through law, propaganda, and even state-sponsored bullying. As reports of the apparitions went abroad, well, local officials were embarrassed. They forced the children to undergo harsh interrogations and even jailed them for a time. The local clergy were hardly more supportive, and many people feared that the apparitions were a hoax perpetrated by one or another political party. On the 13th day of one month, the clergy worked with the civil authorities to actually hijack the children on their way to the place where they customarily saw the lady. But no one could deny the change that was taking place in the lives of Lucia, Jacinta, and Francisco. They got serious about prayer, and they undertook severe fasting and other traditional means of penance. They imposed spiritual order and discipline on their daily life. So their personal conversion made their witness credible to the world. And indeed, the world was taking notice. American and European newspapers stationed reporters in Fatima to track the progress of the story. The apparitions even made it to the front pages of the faraway New York Times. Now, the details of the story were sometimes sensational, but they were true. The lady had given the children certain messages they could share with the world, and others they were to keep secret. Now, speculation ran wild about the content of the three secrets, which were gradually divulged over the next 83 years. What are the secrets of Fatima? The first was a vision of hell, which inspired the children to greater penance for the conversion of sinners. The second secret was about evangelization. The Blessed Virgin called for the consecration of Russia to her Immaculate Heart and asked Catholics to make a communion of reparation on the first Saturday of every month. Now, the third secret was kept under wraps until the turn of the millennium. It included an apocalyptic vision of history as it was about to unfold. Pope Benedict XVI said it was primarily about the suffering of the church. Its message, then, is perennial as much as it was particular. When asked about the hidden secret of Fatima, Pope St. John Paul II would take out his own rosary and tell people that this is the secret of Fatima. The visionaries at Fatima foresaw the great trials of the 20th century, like the rise of communism and the horrors of the world wars. But their secret is still relevant, and it's there in plain sight. It's prayer. It's the way we draw close to Jesus in the mysteries of the rosary.